A key idea to many behavioral therapies is the use of reinforcement to shape and change behavior. However, other techniques are used, such as extinction. And this was used in the study I just talked about with the psychiatric nurse as a behavioral engineer. They used extinction to decrease symptoms of schizophrenia. But let's look at a different type of therapy that uses reinforcement. One successful ABA technique that is used by behavioral therapists is a token economy. And here, desired behaviors are reinforced with a token. That can be something like a sticker, a star on the board, or some type of chip. These tokens are accumulated and can later be exchanged for other items or privileges. For example, a child with ADHD may be put on a token economy wherein he gets a token for every homework assignment that he completes on time. After he accumulates 5 stars, he gets 10 extra minutes of recess. Moreover, if he earns 10 stars, he gets to go on the field trip with the class. The token economy technique has been found to be especially effective in treating drug addiction. So let's look at an example of that. Stephen Higgins and his colleagues conducted a series of studies where they gave cocaine-dependent participants tokens for each drug-free urine sample that they provided. In some of the studies, the value of the tokens increased for each consecutive drug-free sample. So for example, perhaps the first token was worth 25 cents. If they provided a drug-free urine on the next day, it would be increased to 50 cents. On the third day, if they provided a drug-free sample, it would go to 75 cents. Now remember, these were just tokens. They didn't earn actual money. And part of this was because they wanted to make sure that the tokens could be exchanged for appropriate items, meaning they didn't want to give these individuals money and then perhaps risk them taking that money and going out and buying drugs. So again, if drugs were found in the urine, the value of the token decreased to the original starting value. So again, if they had consecutive drug-free urines, the token value increased each time. But if drugs were found in the urine, it went back to the original starting value. In these studies, the researchers found a significant decrease in drug using, especially compared to other therapies, such as Narcotics Anonymous. These individuals spent longer time drug-free than individuals in those other treatments. Given the success of these types of studies, this behavioral approach has been listed by the National Institute on Drug Abuse as the best option for drug addiction, along with medication.